Good evening.
There's a dance.
I'll call this regular meeting of the Fairborn City Schools Board of Education to order Thursday, April 6th, 2017. Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Me too.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mrs. Marshall, call the roll, please.
Mr. Wilson?
Here.
Mrs. Malad?
Here.
Mr. Browning?
Here.
Ms. Luce?
Here.
Mr. McCourt?
In attendance.
All right. Have a motion to approve the agenda with the addendum as presented. You should have an addendum, which is item 13, a separate sheet. I have a motion.
So moved.
Thank you, Mr. Browning.
Second.
Thank you, Ms. Luce.
There are a couple of changes to note on the agenda. We have the addendum that you mentioned. And then on page 9, under executive session to discuss negotiations and compensation and employment of public employees is what that should say. So we need to add and employment after compensation. And then on page 10, we have several items that have been added and one date change. The April 12th SAC meeting has been changed to April 25th. And then we've added events for April 27th, April 29th, May 1st through the 5th, May 4th, May 10th, May 15th, May 16th, the BMS Purple House Public Speaking Competition, May 18th, the BMS Incoming 6th Grade Parent Meeting, and May 18th, the BMS 6th Grade Track and Field Day, and then on May 24th, the FHS Baccalaureate is location to be determined. And that's all the changes I have, so. Any questions about the changes?
No.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
Motion carries. Superintendent's report, Mr. North.
Thank you. First on the agenda is a report from our senior class New York trip, so I'm gonna go ahead and turn this over to Mr. and Mrs. Kirsch, the senior class. Or at least those who are present.
Let's move. Yeah, we need that.
We're moving.
Thank you for allowing us a speaker tonight. I would like to begin by reintroducing to you the 2017 senior class officers. Hello, my name is Titus Smith, and I am the president.
Hello, my name is Vanessa Galloway, and I'm the vice president.
Hello, I'm Chloe Beecraft, and I'm our secretary.
Hello, my name is Eli Smith, and I'm the co-treasurer.
My name is Kelsey Gus, and I'm the co-treasurer.
My name is Sarah Rice, and I'm a historian.
My name is Hannah Borcher, and I'm a historian.
I'm Daniel Dicker, and I'm also a historian.
On behalf of the class of 2017, we would like to sincerely thank you for allowing us to visit one of the greatest cities in the world.
While we were in New York, we were able to experience one of the greatest venues New York has to offer.
We went to the 9/11 Memorial, as well as catching a remarkable view from the top of the One World Trade Center Observatory. We also got to see the Hudson River while we were up there, and a remarkable view of the city.
We visited Wall Street, Chinatown, and Little Italy, which provided us an exposure to many different cultures.
We got to experience riding in the New York City subway, which allowed us to travel to many different places.
We went on an amazing new dance cruise where we bonded through dance and song and into a beautiful nighttime view of the city and the Central Valley.
We walked into the heart of Manhattan, which is the most upbeat square of New York City, known as Times Square.
We also saw the amazing Broadway musical, School of Rock, at the Winter Garden Theater.
We were led into an amazing city by our excellent chaperones, those that were teachers, administrators, community members, parents, grandparents, whose experience in this city led us to great venues and made our trip enjoyable.
As a class, we decided that we wanted to give back while touring New York City. And before we left, we packed up these socks and the baggies with inspirational notes in them that each student got and passed out to the homeless around the city. And this experience was really humbling, and it showed us how blessed we are and how good it feels to give back. We made lots of memories and had many once-in-a-lifetime experiences while in New York City, and we would like to show you the special moments that we captured in the Big Apple.
Again, thank you all for this amazing opportunity to explore such an exhilarating city together as a class while making memories that will be with us for the rest of our lives. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Before you guys take off, I just want to comment. That was a great presentation. Appreciate it, and thanks for how well you represented the school district in New York. So thank you. And by the way, it was fun watching the pictures over the weekend to see what everybody was doing.
They were rolling in.
That's right. Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you again.
Thank you.
Yeah, and good behavior allows the next class to.
That's right.
And thank Mr. and Mrs. Kirsch.
That's
yes.
right.
Yes, appreciate
it. Yes, Tom and Wendy, thank you very much.
Next on the agenda, we have Mr. Mike Eichert, board member at the Greene County Career Center, on behalf of Lebanon City Schools to. Give an update on Lebanon. Fairborn City.
I thought we broke you of that.
You know, it's been a few months for Fairborn City Schools.
Is that where I am tonight?
Oh, that's good.
It's
that's
all
good.
Right.
Update the board.
Please.
Mr. President, board members, thank you very much for the opportunity. Just wanted to give you an update on what's going on at the Career Center. Beginning this fall, we're actually expanding some of our career technical programs. We're going to have a total of 18 programs with the addition of a sports and exercise science and a multidisciplinary Career X program. That, you know, we've got already have, obviously 16 other programs that range from veterinary science to welding to carpentry. They've got the culinary arts. I had brunch today, courtesy of the Food and Hospitality Group. We're doing well, and our numbers are coming up every year now for the last three. Hope to continue to do that in the future. As far as feedback on how well we're doing, the executive director of the Dayton Independent Electrical Contractors visited the junior and senior electrical trade students last month. She wrote back, quote, "I have never been more excited when I left a class as I was on Thursday." And she went on to explain that typically when she talks to students, she gets one or two questions at the end when she says, "Are there any questions?" Well, this was the first time in 6 years that a group asked a lot of questions. Most of them actually were totally engaged and actually listened to her. So she was a little bit surprised and extraordinarily pleased with that. So I just want to leave that. That's as much for the student, for the families and the parents as it is for the board to be very proud of the students that comprise the gang down there. As far as this coming year, we're also expanding, doing some additional things at the various schools within the Greene County. For instance, Xenia is introducing an engineering pathway for grades 6 through 12. They're also expanding Project Lead the Way. Let's see, at Cedarville, they're going to enhance the agricultural education that they're doing out there with mechanical principals and a full-time instructor. Beaver Creek, which has been expanding its STEM-related and Project Lead the Way curriculum for a while, they're going into automation and robotics plus flight and space for eighth graders. boy. Just brushed them. I can't do a thing with them. STEM-related instruction has been a foundation, and the current year saw the addition of engineering and engineering technology course of instruction out at Yellow Springs. So we are expanding the curriculum. We're also, you know, as many of you may or may not know, and I wanted, you know, I'm going to send this to everybody so you can get it out to whomever. But we also have a project search for post high school students which is we do in conjunction with Soin Medical Center. And essentially we take disadvantaged children, young people at this point, and give them opportunity to intern at Soin Medical Center in three different areas, after which we help them then facilitate them finding full-time jobs. So finally, second to finally, just want to let you know that we had just announced the honor roll for this semester, and we had 48 Fairborn students which comprises about 20% of the honor roll students out of 7 schools in the county that were named to it. Finally, the Career Center is celebrating its 50th anniversary with special observances, more to come, planned for September. So, are there any questions?
Great.
If not, I'd like to, one of the things I'm going to cover in my good of the order is the new makerspace facility that's over at the Green County Library in Xenia, and they have quite a bit of high-tech stuff in there that would be beneficial to all of our students throughout Green County. And the only thing you need is a Green County Library card to be able to use the facility. They have 3D printers and laser cutters and CNC milling machines and all kinds of good tools there that if you use materials, the only cost to use the equipment is the use of the materials.
Right. And so, and you know, we're also, and I mentioned it before, and we're not yet ready to break ground or announce anything big, but we have been working now on what we call a Take Flight initiative to bring an aerospace, automotive, and medical series of programs, both headed towards post-high school education as well as industry. That is it's still in the political development stage, but we're working with the state of Ohio in the legislature right now. We've spoken with the governor's people, and with a little bit of luck, we will have some really good news forthcoming on that, and I'll keep you apprised.
So. Mike, I just have one thing. Maybe when you leave, you can take a run over to the park, but we just have over on the girls' softball fields a nice brand new building that students out at the Career Center built for us, from what I understand. Yeah. And did a great job. Looks good sitting out there, and it is being used every day.
Actually, it's been interesting. The building and trades students have been helping not only here but also at the Agricultural Research Center. They have been building run-in sheds for all the pastures out there, so that the horses will have shelter. We can turn when those are done. You can put the horses out during the day, and if in any clement weather, they can just kind of keep themselves dry. So yeah, it's amazing. It's amazing the talent that we have and the ability to do this. Right. And I'm glad we could do it for Fairborn.
Well, yep. Very much
thank
appreciated.
You. Thank you for the update.
I'd just like to add, Mike mentioned the program going on at the medical center for our special needs students who have graduated but still need assistance and preparing for working like everyone else. And I had the opportunity to visit that program last month, and it really, there's a lot of great programs going on at the Career Center, but I guess because of my background as a special needs teacher, that one's a little bit more near and dear to my heart. And just see how students are engaged and being trained in numerous, I mean, you can imagine a hospital, all the different jobs in a hospital, from food service to custodial to maintenance to, it goes on and on and on. And to see students being prepared so that they can live a productive and happy life like we want all of our students to live. And it's just one of the many great programs out there.
Thank you. It's very good that even kids that don't want to go into the hospital business, they learn skills that transfer easily from a hospital. Everybody needs maintenance. Everybody needs to be able to do those things that keep an organization going, and that's what we teach. And we teach the soft. One of the things that really impresses me the most is the engagement of the teachers in teaching soft skills, how to act with your customer. Everybody has customers.
Yeah.
You're mine.
Thank you.
Thanks.
I'm going to break from the superintendent's report for a second. Later on in the board agenda, we have some administrative positions that the board is going to vote on. This was some of these positions was created by some shifts that have been previously approved. One example is Andrea Ferguson moving from assistant principal to principal at Baker Middle School, and we have all those administrative positions filled as long as the board votes in majority. And I'd like to take a moment to introduce those individuals at this time before we go any further. So Jill and Vicki, would you please stand up? Most of you or all of you know Jill as a colleague and teacher for the past 20 years here in Fairborn. We are recommending Jill for the assistant principal opening at the primary school where she's been serving. Beside her is Vicki. Vicki, a few years ago, was actually the assistant principal at Fairborn Primary. She left the district to get principal experience and at Springfield, and in a roundabout way, she returned. We hired her through a consulting contract or a service contract with Montgomery County ESC to serve as our preschool director this past year, and we are recommending her for the principal's position at Fairborn Primary. So Jill and Vicki, thank you very much. We also have with us Brad Holt. Will you please stand? Brad is joining us from Mad River. Brad was an assistant principal for 6 years at their middle school and then was promoted to the high school principal's position. And we are taking advantage of Brad deciding to make a change. I hope you don't mind me saying this. If not, you can either kick me in the shin or you know, tell me to apologize later. But I really admire Brad greatly because Brad shared with us that what he wants to do is find a balance between family and his professional career. And so that's why he applied for this middle school assistant's position to help find that balance. And we're very fortunate to have him on the team. And Brad, thank you. We also have with us Kevin Alexander. Kevin is currently the National Trails Athletic Director, and he will be our athletic director here in Fairborn City Schools for our next school year. He's going to join us a little early this summer because there's a whole lot of things that one person has to do in a very big department. Talk about a one-man show. But we have Kevin here also, and I'm just, as I've said to all you in our board notes, I believe that we have one just phenomenal team that's with experience within the community, with experience with outside the community, and we just have a top-notch administrative team, and I could not be more pleased with the recommendations that we're making to the board tonight with these four individuals. So with that, I'm going to move to the very last part of the superintendent's report. You know, one of the things I learned very quickly here is Fairborn is a community and a school district strong tradition and just a very solid educational institute. And that, and I've said this before, and I say this sincerely, not because I'm trying to suck up, because I don't I don't need to. I still have 3 years in my contract. But the truth is, it starts with the foundation of the Board of Education. And Fairborn has had many very fine board members over the years to build that strong tradition. And tonight, it is, Nicole, my pleasure to share some information regarding the current Board of Education. So, Nicole, I'm going to ask the board members, if you'll please step out front there beside Nicole. And it's our pleasure, Nicole, my pleasure. I'll wait till you get out there. To announce the board has received the Gold Level Award from the Ohio School Boards Association Southwest Region for their outstanding work in the region. The award's based on a checklist of 26 items which define specific steps and actions taken by the Board of Education to meet the goals. A Board of Education can receive a bronze level, a silver level, or a gold level, or not any award at all. And as I've said, It's our pleasure to be able to announce that the Fairborn education was recognized at the OSBA Southwest Region Spring Conference, and congratulations to the Fairborn Board of Education for your hard work and your commitment as those before you to the Fairborn City Schools, students and staff. Thank you very much. And with that, I conclude the superintendent report.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. North, and also extend my thanks to the central office team and their preparation and filing for the OSBA award. I know it's took a lot of work to put that together, so we appreciate that
yes.
effort.
They really gay hearts. Thank you.
Well, we move on to recognition of visitors. If anybody would like to address the board, please step up to the microphone, state your name and address, and we allow 30 minutes for this.
30.
Please. for everybody,
okay.
You know, 5 minutes per person. Please limit your comments to five minutes.
I promise you I will not take 30 minutes. I'm Marilyn McCauley from the Fairborn City Council. And just thank you for this opportunity to share some of the happenings that's going on with the city. First of all, we want to say thanks again for your participation in the Community Reinvestment Area Compensation Agreement, better known as CRA. That's an easier way to say it for sure. The good news from that is the company has signed a contract for the land, so we're moving. I can't tell you right now who the company is, but it has the prospects of 150 jobs for the city. So that's great news.
Good.
Tonight, I bring to each of you a copy of the State of the City report for this year, but a couple items that's not in there. This first one I think is, but the city of Fairborn grew 3% this past year. And not only did they grow by 3%, we're the third fastest growing community in the Miami Valley region. So that was really great news for us. Also, a number that's not in here, we just received word that the median household income from Fairborn increased over $600 the last few years. Now, that may not sound like a lot of money, but that's income that's gone up by $600 that's been spread across over almost 16,000 households. So that means a lot of people coming to the city are making a lot more income than we've ever seen before. So it is a significant number when you look at it from that perspective. So we're very pleased about that. And that's all I have for this evening, and I will give you your reports. Maybe you want to put a copy in the library so the kids can understand what's going on in the city.
We're in the media.
Yeah. Ask her if she has a PDF, because that's her.
Thank you. Thank you, Marilyn.
That's nice. Sure thing.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, Marilyn.
Thank you, Marilyn.
Thank you, sweetie.
Thank you.
Anyone else? Seeing no one, we'll close recognition of visitors and move to item 7, approve minutes of the Thursday, March 2nd regular meeting. Be it resolved that since the minutes have been distributed to board members in accordance with legal statute, reading of the minutes be hereby waived and further such minutes be approved. May I have a motion?
So moved.
Thank you, Mr. McCourt.
Second.
Thank you, Mrs. Malad.
All those in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Any opposed?
Motion carries. Item 8, Treasurer's Report.
It's me.
Am I moving?
Yeah.
We have it in front of us.
Getting your exercise tonight.
It is pretty exciting, though, I gotta say. I mean, highlight
of everyone's month.
All right,
fine.
It's up to you.
Okay,
so
you can
be on.
This page.
make sure I've looked at it.
Was he not going to get up? Really? Jeez. All right, this month, this will be really quick, so I'm sorry you guys did get up. This month, we're going over the February 28, 2017 month end. The original report I sent to the board did say February 31st, which there is no such thing. This has been corrected. The copies that are in the back are corrected, so. Yeah. First, we're going to look at the revenues compared to the same time last year. Overall, revenues were lower by $1.6 million. This is just mostly due to the real estate tax revenue, timing of advances, and things like that. Other operating revenue is down, which we knew was going to happen because of the Medicaid cost reimbursement from the prior year that was a one-time receipt. Overall, we've received about 71% of the total forecast amount for the year, for forecast year ending June 30th. Our expenditures were about $12,000 lower than the prior same time. It's pretty much running at the same as it was last month. And we had spent about 62.86% of what's been forecast for the year. We'll be updating the forecast at the next meeting in May. So we'll see some of these numbers change a little bit. Our general fund cash balance in the general fund only was $22.3 million. Last year at the same time it was $18.5 million, which is an increase of 3.8. That's before any encumbrances, which are outstanding purchase orders. And so it was $18.2 million unencumbered balance. This just shows a graph of where we were at. This is just our unencumbered balance compared to the same time last year. And you can see the roller coaster that happens every month. As of February 28th, we had about $2.3 million in expenses for personnel costs and $1 million in other expenses, and that's average throughout the year. Overall, $3.4 million, and we had 340 certified staff and 261 classified staff. Now, these are including substitutes that we pay. This is a schedule of the investments that we have at the moment. This is going to be changing over the next couple of months because we do have some funds from where we sold bonds for the building project, and that's going to be invested to kind of match a construction schedule once we get one. So we're still in the planning stages of that. And this is just the district's cash reconciliation, and we reconciled to zero. It's cut off a little bit, but which is what we want to do every month. That's all I have for the financial report. I do want to mention with the construction stuff, we will be presenting the board with a contract for the folks that you guys met last month, the owner's agent, the commissioning agent, and the architects, most importantly. We're still waiting. We're still in negotiations with them, and the state basically is still in negotiations with them. And so when that comes in, I may be asking the board for a special board meeting before the end of, because we don't want to wait until May. So hopefully if that comes through, we may have a special board meeting in the near future. So that's all I have. Any questions from my board members out in the audience, wherever you guys are?
Okay.
Marshall, we'll move on to item 9, the consent agenda, which runs from page 2, page 6.
Right.
I'd like to call your attention to, on page 5, item 11, we have Molly Fife, a preschool assistant, retiring after 25 years of service. So we'll have a tribute for her years of service. And Stephanie Webb, a digital learning assistant, with a resolution of tribute for 11 years of service with Fairborn City Schools. So. Wish them both the best in their retirement.
Stephanie Webb, please.
I have a Motion on the consent agenda, please.
So moved.
Thank you, Mr. Browning.
Second.
Thank you, Mr. McCourt. Any additional comments, questions?
Don't have any.
Mrs. Marshall, please call the roll.
Mr. Browning?
Yes.
Mr. McCourt?
Yes.
Ms. Luce?
Yes.
Mrs. Malott?
Yes.
Mr. Wilson?
Yes. Motion carries. Item D, administrative employment. This is we have four people anxiously awaiting this vote here. I'm very pleased at the process that's been carried out here to post the positions and interview folks, and the hard work of making the recommendation to us.
It's been a lot of work. He's busy.
So, can I have a motion?
So moved.
Thank you, Mr. Browning.
Second.
Thank you, Ms. Luce. Any additional comments, questions?
Yes, if I may, please. You know, it's when Mark came on board and three of the five board members came in as new board members, we asked Mark to take a good look around the district and where we might need changes or where changes are evident coming through either people moving away or retirement. But we asked him to take a good look and bring together a good, strong administrative staff consisting of, and our preference was to, I guess maybe three things we looked at when the three board members came in was hire good people, keep good people, and promote within. And I think we and Mark and the staff at Central Office have really proven that they've done this. With two of the five, or yeah, two of the five that are here with us tonight. I mean, I go back a long way with two of the young ladies, and it's wonderful, wonderful to see, you know, they come up within their job, and we have nothing but well wishes for both of you, for all of you. But and I think I may have said this earlier to one of them, I believe my job as a board member, and I believe our job as a board is to do what we can do to make you very successful. That's exactly what we want to do. And so with that said, you know, I mean, I appreciate all of you. Always said too, if there's anything we can do, just shout. So, you know, we know right now we've got an outstanding team together administratively, and other people in the district have wanted this, have asked us to do this, and teachers along with secretaries and other people within our buildings. Folks, we have that right now. And I beg you, I ask of all of you staff members, secretaries, get behind these folks, and let's all go forward together, and let's make this place just as great as it's ever been. So thank you all for being here.
I guess just one comment also. Mark, correct me if I'm wrong, we had a high number of applicants for these jobs.
Yeah, we had over 100 applicants for the middle school assistant principals. We had over 70 applicants for the AD principals, for the AD mm-hmm. position. We had something like 40 applicants for the assistant and primary principal. So those are extremely high numbers
right.
of applications.
And the reason I want to say it, to me, that says something for the district of people wanting to come to the district now. And it says something for the quality of the people that are selected for the positions. So thank you. Glad you're here.
Yeah. Welcome.
Yeah. And with the, especially at the primary school, with the impending construction of new facilities, your roles will be magnified in what you're doing. So.
And exciting.
Yes, exciting and daunting and hopefully will be happy occasion in a year and 2.5 years or so when we open the the new building.
Okay.
Okay, Mrs. Marshall, any other comments? Ms. Marshall, call the roll.
Mr. Browning?
Absolutely, yes.
Ms. Luce?
Yes.
Mr. McCourt?
Proudly, yes.
Mrs. Malad?
Yes.
Mr. Wilson?
Enthusiastically, yes.
Sickening.
Motion carries. Welcome aboard.
Welcome.
Absolutely.
Mr. Wilson, this might be a good time for those that have other commitments in their districts that they're currently employed in to leave at this time if you'd like to.
Please.
Oh.
Go.
See ya. Absolutely,
thanks.
Guys. Absolutely.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Be free. Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
We'll move on to item 10, the Treasurer's Office, the February 17 financial report, approve appropriation modification for 16-17, and approve then and now purchase orders. May I have a motion?
So moved.
Thank you, Ms. Luce.
Second.
Thank you, Mrs. Malad. Marshall?
The appropriation modifications are for the building project. We've uh-huh. added additional appropriations for that. And the then and now purchase orders are, again, from last month. We had the legal fees that I did not have a purchase order in place for. And the other one is we had a third party give us accounts payable services, and they changed the name of the company at some point and didn't tell us. So we had a purchase order in place, but it was to the wrong company, so we had to rewrite another purchase order. So it's on here as well.
Little details.
Yes. Can't change it up. We actually sent the check and it came back. So
as long as they didn't cash the check twice, we're
right.
All right.
Yeah.
Right.
Call the roll, please.
Ms. Luce?
Yes.
Mrs. Malad?
Yes.
Mr. Browning?
Yes.
Mr. McCourt?
Yes.
Mr. Wilson?
Yes. Motion carries. Item D, resolution authorizing the treasurer, CFO, to retroactively pay FCEA unit members in accordance with arbitration and court ruling. I have a motion.
So moved.
Thank you, Mrs. Malad.
Second.
Thank you, Ms. Luce.
Ready for roll?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Mrs. Malad?
Yes.
Ms. Luce?
Yes.
Mr. Browning?
Abstain. And just so everybody knows, my wife is a member of the FCEA union, so I'm abstaining.
Mr. McCourt?
Yes.
Mr. Wilson?
Yes. Motion carries.
Guys. Like any of us.
Just couldn't help it, could you?
I was waiting for an enthusiastically yes.
It wasn't that, was there? No, darn it. Go back.
Redo.
Scooby-Doo ending.
Item 11, gifts and donations. Mr. McCourt.
Oh, indeed. Once again, you know, gifts and donations are something that I don't think we could do without. It continues, I think, to keep that tie between people who donate, be it people in our buildings or out of our buildings, people incoming, new people, old alumni, or people that have been around for a long time. But we do very much appreciate those donations. From Cindy Scarpelli at Sipsy Klein, 40 pairs of shoes for the homeless. Diana Hensley, $10 for the Archery Club. William and Deborah Myers, $100 to the FHS New York City trip. William Nebus, the Nebuses, they just keep on giving. Trophy for the Spelling Bee. The Rex Ackerman Relay donation, and for any of you who don't know, Rex Ackerman was a board member here, a teacher here, a coach here, he was around for a long time, coached me. So you know he was around for a long time. But Kevin Ackerman, $100. Bill and Janine Blankenship, $100. Janie Clifton for $100. The Gayhart family and J.R. Remick, $100. That is, I'm going to say this opposite because I've always said the ladies go first. Judy and Jack, Pam and Chris, Amy and Kurt, and Carrie and Scott. Thank you to the Gayhart family. Sandy and Ed Nebus, Jamie's Tire Service, Norma and Dan Kirkpatrick, Mark North, Pat and Steve Quinter, TCA Graphics, Town and Country, Animal Clinic, and Tim and Kathy Wolf, all giving donations of $100. So, did I say Ed and Gibbons? Sandy and Ed Gibbons also. Sorry about that, Ed. But again, thanks so much for your donations. We do appreciate them.
I have a motion.
So moved.
Thank you, Mr. Browning.
Second.
Thank you, Mr. McCourt.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
Motion carries. And item 12, we also have acknowledgement of contributions for the Hall of Honor.
Would you like me to?
Sure.
I would be honored. Hall of Honor, of course, is something that we just love in this town, and a lot of people hanging on the wall, and a lot of people we remember for their contributions. But Jeffrey L. Billows, M.D., $100, or a Skyhawk donor. Ann Armstrong Ingoldsby, a blue donor. Joan Doctel, of course, a Skyhawk donor. Jack and Judy Gayhart, again, a Skyhawk donor. Richard Helms, a Skyhawk donor. Laura and Betsy Mayer, Laurel and Betsy Mayer, a blue donor. James McMillan, a silver donor. David and Terry Nebus, $100 for a Skyhawk donor. And, of course, Wright Pinson, a classmate of mine, for a $500 gold donor. So, again, thank you so much for that and for that program.
Thank you, Mr. McCourt. We'll move on to item 13, which is new business for us with a variety of things here. And this is where the addendum is for item G. I have a motion.
So moved.
Thank you, Mrs. Malone.
Second.
Any discussion on any of these items?
Would you like me to talk about the first few?
Sure.
So the Greene County Educational Service Center, we contract with them for special ed services. They provide a variety of services to the district for the special education program. And the OneView, the eSchool View for OneView software program will allow our parents to register online.
Ooh.
Yes, we're all us parents are very excited about that. So, and then, right. So, and hopefully that will make it easier for our parents. Hopefully that will help just with that whole registration process. And then item C is approve the staff network and internet acceptable user safety agreement. That hadn't been updated in a very long time. That's just something that we felt needed
right.
updated.
Right.
So.
Good deal.
And the rest of it's just
right.
out of state.
Right.
Pretty self-explanatory.
Any other questions, mm-hmm. comments? Call the roll, please.
Mrs. Malad?
Yes.
Mr. Browning?
Yes.
Ms. Luce?
Yes.
Mr. McCourt?
Yes.
Mr. Wilson?
Yes. Motion carries. Okay, we'll move on to board reports and good of the order. Want to go first?
Sure.
Okay.
I just have two things tonight. I want to say congratulations to Joan Dottel. On Monday night, we dedicated our softball field to her. And as Mr. McCourt said, our Career Center students made our new shed out there mm-hmm. for the softball field. And then near and dear to my heart, Mr. Dysinger, that teaches here at the high school, made a new metal sign to put on the building. For Joan, and it was a nice little ceremony. We had a nice turnout. It was just good to see one of our own recognized like that while she's here to receive it, and it was just a fun night. We were all were there for that, and congratulations to Joan. And the second thing is, Friday, April 28th, will be our Hall of Honor here at the high school. I believe it starts at 7. The committee has worked very hard on that. I know Ed rounds up the committee there, and we have 7 inductees this year that are highly deserving, and it's just a really good night for everyone to come in and show their respect for those people. We have the students here, the band plays, and we just have a really nice reception after the ceremony in the Commons, and it's just a really good Skyhawk night for everybody to come. So I just want to remind everybody of that, to come and join us if you can. That's it.
Okay, first of all, I'd like to welcome back to work Patsy Trippensy. She's been off, had some surgery, and I understand she's back to work this week, right? I hear she's wearing a little boot that I'm sure is not in her fashion repertoire, but she's forced to wear as she hobbles around the central office. But we've all, I think, tried to keep in touch with her through the whole thing, and it's just good to see her back. Central office staff, I just, you know, I maybe might have been a week ago, but I attended another one of our policy meetings, and this new policy that's coming out, it's been 13 years since we've updated policy, and you just can't imagine the work that goes in to the policy. And I was so impressed the other day. We were all sitting around a table, and Gary and Ed were there, and Norm, the guy that takes care of the policy for us, or is helping us with the policy, he would ask questions, and these two guys, I don't know how they do it, but he'll ask a question 10, 20 years ago, and it pops into these guys' heads, and they come out with the answer, and you know, that doesn't come with just a few years service and experience, but a bunch. And Ed, you know, when you go, we're certainly going to miss you, and don't ever change your phone number, because we'll probably be calling. But Gary, I do appreciate both of you gentlemen being there and helping us get through policy, because folks, when we get this policy done, it's going to be so great, so user friendly, that staff, administrators, they just go to this thing. If it's a question of what policy is, or if we have a problem, what is policy? Boom. I mean, hell, even I can get to it, and I'm so computer stupid, it's unreal. But these people have put in hours and hours and hours and hours and hours. And so to all central staff, and I know Sue Brackenhoff is as well. She wasn't in my meeting. She didn't come to my meetings. but we do appreciate you all very, very much in assisting us. Pam, you as well. You know, it takes a big crew of people to run a district, and these people are top-notch folks, and we're just tickled to death to have them. Custodians, I've been around the buildings again last week, this week. Asked for some favors, and I told my kids when I was raising them up, the people you want to get to know are the custodians, because they can move mountains for you, and they can take a not so pretty building and sure put a coat of wax on it and make it shine like a new penny. But our custodians in all of our buildings do a great job for us, and we appreciate them. To my friends Twyla and Gretchen, I just want to thank you for your support, and thank you for what you're doing, of which I cannot say. So thank you. And finally, you know, Mark has been here for maybe 7 months, eight months.
I don't know. He thinks he's in Lebanon still.
Yeah.
Just kidding.
But, you know, when Mark come on, the board sat down with him, and we talked about some expectations on our side. And Mark says, you know, he was all in for it. He said, you know, I'd probably put maybe like a 2-year time window on what you all want, and not that he's done, but 7 months. And you just sit back and look at what we've done in our district, the staff, the administrative staff that he and Nicole have put together, Folks, we're very fortunate to have these people, and they're going to help us down the road even more. And you know, it's great to work with a bunch of professional people, you know, that I feel is not just we're colleagues, but we're friends. You know, we can pick up the phone and call one another, and that means the world to me. So everybody, thank you for what you do. And for what you do that I can't say. Thanks.
Yeah. Okay. A couple things I want to talk about. The band concert last month. It's interesting to me watching the younger ages. You know, you got middle school through high school, and it's amazing the improvement that you see as they progress through the ages, and all in the same night, you can see what's going on. So I really enjoyed that band concert, the Drumline. Went to the first indoor Drumline on Northmont, and then went to the last one at Nutter Center this past week, and it's amazing the improvement. This was the championships this last Sunday, and it's amazing to me the improvement from the beginning of the year to the end competition in the Drumline and the costumes. If there's videos out on Facebook and stuff, if people get a chance to watch them, because I really enjoyed it.
You still have your hearing?
Yeah, I still have my hearing.
What?
What? Yeah. Pink Flamingos. I see a couple people in the room. Around town, in the past couple years, you see pink flamingos in yards. Well, they're going to be sprouting up again. And the contact information is on Facebook. I think it's, is it Karen? Yvonne? Yeah. That's coordinating again. So everybody pitch in and help move the flamingos around town if you can. Then the final thing I wanted to comment about was Joan Dottel, the field being named after Joan with the scoreboard and everything. One comment she made is she was very glad it wasn't in memory of, you know, that she got a chance to see it. But it was well-deserved for Joan. So thanks.
Yes. So This past month, I had the privilege of acting as the MC for the Purple House Public Speaking Competition, their first round. I did this last year as well, so it was nice to be back and work with Marcy Boone and her team of speakers. She does a fabulous job of pulling together some really interesting and great people to come talk to that seventh grade house about how to be a public speaker. Mike Newsom from the Fatherhood Initiative at Montgomery County Job and Family Services, Renda Snyder from the Dayton Fuddy Bone, Brooke Moore from Channel 2 News, and Rick Perales. And then I'm assuming she had to pay her son, Nathan, something to step in last minute to be the motivational speaker, but he did a great job. So I think there's a correction on the calendar. I have on my calendar that it's actually the 17th that the follow-up event is happening. And I hope that I know when it is because I'm supposed to lead the thing. It should be the 17th. But I highly encourage if any of you are interested to come out and check out these. The seventh graders will be competing over the next month to give the speech in their category. So comedy, and I think they even throw a few singers in there. So you've seen nothing till you've seen seventh graders stand up and do stand-up comedy, okay? Their own material. So if you want to come out on that morning and give them a listen, they get to compete for prizes, and it's pretty fun. It's a pretty fun thing to see. So, and all of those famous people speakers come back and are the judges. So it's a really neat program that she's got set up there, and I enjoy being a part of it. So.
Yeah. To add to those comments, I was there as an observer, and during the fatherhood session, the question was asked, "What does a father mean to you?" And the responses were kind of jaw-dropping.
Yeah, if you want a good picture of what our kids are dealing with on a daily basis, that'll show it to you. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I think it was particularly beneficial to have Representative Perales there to hear some of those responses, because one of the responses was nothing.
Yeah. It's kind of heartbreaking.
Yeah. So. Okay. Moving on to my fun of the last month. I spoke a little bit when Mr. Eaker was up here about the Greene County Library. They had an open house breakfast for their new makerspace over in the library in Xenia. And it's a pretty phenomenal little facility for people of all ages to come in and use some really exceptionally high-quality equipment for virtually no cost. And they have people there that will assist you in learning how to use it. They have embroidery machines and serging machines, and they have a sound studio over there. In addition to the 3D printers and other stuff that I mentioned earlier. So it would be well worth investigating. I forwarded contact information to Dr. Brackenoff on this, so to get get some of our students involved in some of these. Also attended a morning session that was put on by Five Rivers Metro Parks of Leave No Child Inside, which had some really intriguing ideas about how to use the open spaces in the school as part of the curriculum for, you know, if you're growing something, you know, plot out the things. So you've got math and science stuff going on, and in addition, you know, to the obvious biology stuff of, you know, why do the plants grow and those kinds of things. Plus, you can develop some music things in there. They've got a whole diagram of how to lay that stuff out. So, attended the OSBA regional conference with a couple of the other board members where we received this award. And that was a long evening. also, the board policy update meetings, which we've got another one coming up on Monday. Student and staff recorder, that was a nice event, and we do have that on our calendar for May 10th for the next one. Part of my tutoring, as I walk down the halls in the primary school, there's a wall up there. It's why do I love Fairborn Primary School? And it's really quite touching to read some of the things that the children have written on there. But, you know, most of them are expressing a deep gratitude and appreciation for the teaching staff there at the school. So that's really great to see that the students that. Some of them are saying things like, I love math, or, you know, recess. Or, you know,
lunch. Like
but the big majority of them are appreciation for the staff there at the primary. This past Saturday in the cold, I had 35 of the JROTC students out there in the park helping me mow down honeysuckle and pull it out of the woods. And then got an event coming up on the 24th of April at 6:30. Dennis Kucinich will be at the Miami Valley Unitarian Universalist Fellowship to have a press conference and question and answer session on the impact of privatization on our public schools. So I will get that information to Ms. Gayhart for putting up on the website, and hope we can get that facility packed with people expressing that. So that's it for me.
Point of order. I have a couple more things. Athletic department came to me and wanted to get some clay for a couple of the baseball fields, and we were able to go to formerly CMEX, now Fairborn Cement Company, and get a couple truckloads of clay. So just thank you to the folks out at the cement plant for continuing to support Fairborn City Schools, and they keep doing it, whatever you know they can do, and within reason, they come out and do it for us. So most certainly want to say thanks. And I want to say a huge, huge thanks to Mark for getting a couple of us board members involved in a dodgeball contest.
Yeah, kind of last minute. It.
And I think he just wanted to see how well my knee was progressing, but we played dodgeball when we didn't last too long, let's just put it that way. But the nice thing was everybody wanted to get Mark, so he was usually the first one out. But thank you, sir, and hopefully next year I'll be out of town. But, but thanks. We had a great time with the kids, and it was a good event.
It
so
was
thanks,
fun.
And thank you once again.
Who knew better?
He's gone and videotaped it.
Anybody
else?
No.
Okay. Move on to item 15, executive session to discuss negotiations, compensation, and employment of public employees. Superintendent and the treasurer will be in attendance in addition to the board. May I have a motion, and no action is expected.
So moved.
Thank you, Mr. Browning.
Second.
Thank you, Mr. McCourt.
Mr. Browning?
Yes.
Mr. McCourt?
Yes.
Ms. Luce?
Yes.
Mrs. Malott?
Yes.
Mr. Wilson?
Yes. Motion carries. We are now in executive session.